Okay, so that means after finishing up this concept, we are done with financial mathematics. What I will do is I will do other topics, and obviously I will do questions, exam questions that involves all of these topics together. Okay, so today we're gonna focus on exchange rate and inflation. We're gonna focus here on exchange rate and inflation. So, nonetheless, if you do not understand, make sure that you ask your questions as much as you can, okay? But before I can even start with exercises, I would love to do the examples because the examples are in a way to help us to understand how does the basic actually works. So remember, here we are talking about the exchange and inflation. So when you talk about the exchange rate, what are we actually talking about? You know, worldwide, remember, since we're talking finance, you have to understand that around the world, each and every country has its own currency. So, what do I mean when I talk about the currency? It has its own money that they use to buy at the shops, or money that they use to pay the employees, or whatever the cases it could be. Right. So, for an example, we are in South Africa, and the currency for South Africa, we use the rand. Right. Now, let's take, for an example, USA. I know USA is one of the most popular country that we can all relate. So, USA, they do not use rands. Meaning, if you are in USA and you want to buy your bread at the store, you're not gonna pay in rands. You're gonna pay in what we call the dollars. So, meaning dollars are the dollars is the currency that they use in America. So now you have to understand that the level of the countries between South Africa and America, it is not the same. Now, meaning our currency, it is a little bit lower than the currency in America. So that's why most of the times, if you work in America and you decide to come to South Africa, and you convert your dollar money or your dollar currency into rands, you will see that your money will be much more higher than when you have it in America. So that's a sign that shows that our country, it is still under the development and our currency is a little bit weaker compared to the currency in America. So the thing is, if you have your rents and you want to buy in America, there must be exchange of what? Of the currency. So that's what we're actually doing in this concept. Okay, so we call that the exchange rate. So we say the exchange rate is the value of one currency converted to another currency. For an example, if you take your rent and you convert it into which currency? Dollars, right? This is the exchange rate. Now, this is what I want us to do. Okay, let me fix this. This is what I want us to do. I want us to do this example because this topic, it is quite straightforward. It's not that challenging or difficult. So example number one, it reads as follows. Example number one, it says to us, you are planning to take a trip to America. If the exchange rate is $1 is equals to 14.52 rand, how many dollars will you have if you have 1,800 rand? Right. So now, according to this equation over here, according to this exchange rate equation over here, they say to us, $1, it corresponds with 14 rand and 52 cents. That's what this equation says, right? But now what's happening here is they want to know if you have 1,800 rand, what does 1,800 rand looks like when we convert it into the dollars. We want to know how much is 1,800 rand in dollars. So in this case, we don't know how many dollars do we want or how many dollars are we looking for. So instead, on this side of the dollars, I'm just gonna write my X, right? Because the X indicates the unknown. I don't know these dollars. How much is this dollars? It's X dollars. So now I want to know that 1,800 rand will correspond with how many dollars. So that's why here I just wrote my X. And therefore, using these two equations over here, this is equation one and this is equation two. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to cross multiply, meaning I'm going to say X multiply by 14, right? And I'm going to say my dollar multiply by 1,108. So that means X multiply by that is going to be X multiply by R14,52, which will be equals to 1,800 multiply by dollar will be my what? My 1,000. It will be my. One thousand 800 rand multiplied by the dollar, which is this dollar over here. Remember, we are just cross multiplying. And therefore, when I punch this on my calculator, remember, I'm looking for X. So I'm going to have to divide this side by 14 rand and 52 cents. I'm also going to divide this side by 14 rand and 52 cents. So 14 rand and 52 cents will cancel 14 rand and 52 cents. And therefore, my X on this side of the equation is going to be equals to, I'm going to say 1,800 rand divided by 14,52. And therefore, to two decimal places, I get how many dollars? 123 and 97. Therefore, this will be my answer. Remember, what was the question? How many dollars will you have if you have 1,800 rand? Therefore, we're going to have these dollars over there when we have 1,800 rand. So that's how we go about, for example, number one. Right, so I guess that we do not have questions regarding this example. So that means I'm gonna jump to the other example. Now, example number two, it reads as follows. It says to us, Tom is planning to take a trip to Japan, right? This is Tom wants to go to Japan. If the exchange is We use the Japanese yen, okay? We use the Japanese yen. That's the currency that they use in Japan. We say it's Japanese yen. So Japanese 1 yen will correspond with 6 rand and 37 cents. How many rands will he need to receive 1,000 yen? Right? So we have the equation over here, right? That's the most important thing. For exchange rate, we have the equation for exchange rate over here. They say Japanese yen, 1 Japanese yen is the same as how much? Is the same as 6 rand and 37 cents. So now what's happening here is that we want to know how much is 1,000 yen in rands. In rands, we want to know. How much is 1,000 yen in rands? So we have the equation that converts from yen to rands or from rands to yen, right? This equation is the one that we use to convert. So if we have 1,000 yen, if we have 1,000 yen, how many rands do we have? I'll just say X because on this side of the equation, I'm writing rands. On this side of the equation, I'm writing my Japanese yen. So now again, we managed to formulate two equations over here where we have equation number one and we have equation number two. Now, when we have two equations, when we have two equations, just like this. What are we then going to do? Remember, it's simple. Again, we're going to have to cross multiply. I'm going to say x multiply by 1 yen, 6 rand and 37 cents multiply by 1,000 Japanese yen. Basically, that's what I'm actually going to do at this point in time. Right? So now, in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say 1 multiply by that one is going to be x multiply by 1 yen is equals to, when I say 1,000 multiply by 6, let me use my calculator. I'm going to say 1,000 multiply by 6,37. And therefore, in this case, how much do I get? Let me see on my calculator. If you have the answer, you can tell me now. I don't know what's happening with this.
6,370.
Exactly. In okay, remember we said this rand multiply by that yen, right? We get R 6,370 multiplied by yen again. Let's not forget that we still have yen. And therefore, I divide both sides by yen. I divide by yen on this side of the equation. I also divide by yen on that side of the equation. And I'm gonna left with my x. And therefore, in this case, my x will be the same as 6,370 rand. So that means 1,000 yen. When you go to Japan and they give you 1,000 yen at this point in time using this equation, when they give you 1,000 yen, just know that they gave you 6,370 rand in RSA rands. So you see, this is simple, this is straightforward. You don't have to panic or you don't have to stress yourself. This is just how simply we go about for these kind of questions. It's just a simple conversion. Now we are done with the examples, and then we're gonna jump to the exercises, right? So those examples were easy. They were quite straightforward because we were just using basically they were based on the basic, okay, on the basics. Now we're gonna start with exercise number one, where it says to us, on the 21st January 2011, the exchange rate indicated that for $1, you will receive 7 rand and 7 cents. Right? So this can make up an equation. What equation? The exchange rate equation. So in this case, the exchange rate equation, that means $1 is gonna be the same as what? $1 is going to be the same as what? As 7 rand and 7 cents. You see it? This is the exchange rate equation that we're going to use to convert throughout. Now, let's try to answer question number 1.1. Now, question number 1.1, it says to us, how many rand will you need to get $455? So if how many rands, right? So how many rands? The thing is, we don't know how many rands. We'll just write X rands. So X rands will correspond with how many dollars? 455. So basically, this is what we are looking for. We want to know how many rands will be the same as $455, right? It is still the same thing. Same thing as what we did in the examples, by the way. So to get how many rands, we'll just write X rand. Therefore, will you need to get this? So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna convert, right? Remember using our equation. Okay, I can start it from the fresh so that you get used to how to solve it. You can solve it like this. If you want to, you can start with your equation. Our equation is $1 correspond with 7.07, and therefore this side it is the dollars. You see, this side we use the dollars. So meaning, how many dollars do we have there? We have $455, and therefore we want to calculate X, which is in rands, right? We don't know how much is this. So using this equation over here, we cross multiply We're going to say 1 multiplied by x, $1 multiplied by x. It will give us x multiplied by the $1, which is equals to 7,07 multiplied by 455. So we go to our calculator, 7,07 multiplied by 455. And therefore, on my calculator, I get in rands 3,216 and how many cents? 85 cents multiplied by the dollars, right? Because I cross multiply this to that, then I cross multiply this to that. I just multiply them. And therefore, in this case, I'm going to divide by dollar and then I'm going to left with my x. So that means in this case, my x will remain as the very same value that we got over there, which is 3,216,85. And therefore, this will be our final answer to 1.1. Now we move to question number 1.2, which says to us, how many dollars? Now we are looking for dollars, right? So we're still going to use the exchange rate equation, which says $1 is the same as 7 rand and 7 cents. So how many dollars? We don't know how many dollars. We'll just write X dollars there. How many dollars, right? Will you get for 566 rand? Or if you want to exchange your dollars, I mean your rand into dollars, how many dollars are we talking about? Again, here we're going to have to cross multiply. 7 multiplied by this, we're going to have 7,07 multiplied by x. It's gonna be equals to dollars. Let me not forget my dollars there, right? And therefore, this multiplied by that will be 566 comma dollars, right? Oh, let me in fact let me not let me eliminate dollar here. I don't like it like this. Let's just do it like this. And therefore, what are we going to do? We're gonna divide both sides by 7 rand. And the 7 cents, right? So I'm gonna say 566 divided by 7,07. Therefore, how many dollars do we get? So our x in this case, remember rand will cancel rand. We left with dollars, so we're gonna left with 80 commas to two decimal places. It's 80,06 dollars, and therefore this will be our final answer to question number 1.2. So I would like to ask, is this difficult, guys?
No, sir, I'd like to ask a question.
Yes, no problem.
Is it a must to write the 7,07 multiplied by x and then say it's equals to
Is it a must to do what?
566?
Is it a must to write
To
this?
write. No, sir. Under the
Oh,
equation thing,
this.
multiply by a dollar. Yes, sir.
It's not a must, by the way. I'm just doing it like this because I don't want you to mess up the units, you know, the rands, in fact, not the units. I don't want you to mess up the rands. But if you can see,
Okay, sir.
it's fine. It is not a must. If you can see how it goes, it is really fine. It is not a must. But it matters that on your final answer, we need the rands over there, right? So that we can see what are we actually calculating here. But here, during the process of calculation, it's fine. You don't have to do that. Okay. Awesome. Thank you, guys. Then that means we continue. Now, here is the second example. I will give you time to do it. So now let's do it then. Example, this exercise number two. Yeah. So they say if the exchange rate is $1 is equals to 13 rand and 69 cents, And the euro is 1 euro is equals to 11 rand and 52 cents. Determine what the exchange rate between the dollar and euro is. So meaning we want to know what is the exchange rate between euro and the dollar, right? Sorry about that. So basically, we want to know what is $1 in euros. Or you can say you want to know what is 1 euro in dollars. So basically, we want to determine the exchange rate between dollar and the euro. We are here. We are here. This is where we are. We want to know $1 is equals to how many euros? Or you can say 1 euro is equals to how many dollars? We want exchange rate between these two currencies, right? It's fine. So let's say for an example, let's say $1 is equals to how many euros in euro, right? Is equals to how many euros? This is what we want to do. This is what we want to solve. The problem is we don't have the exchange rate equation between dollar and the euro. We have the exchange rate equation between dollar and the rand. We have exchange rate equation between euro and the rand. We don't have between dollar and the euro. We have dollar and the rand, euro and the rand. And we want dollar and euro, and we don't have that. So we cannot do this. It's going to be hard for us to do this. So what are we going to do? We can see that the rand is common here, and then rand, it is also appearing on the other equation, right? It's fine if that is actually the case. So you can do it in many different ways, however you want to do it. Like you can just divide by looking for a ratio, which is fine. You can look for a ratio. I'll show you the other way, right? Let me start with this way. I'll show you the ratio way, using the ratio, because what we did previously, I was actually using the ratio, but I'll show you the another way to do it. So let's start with the first way. Now here we have $1, right? $1 in this case. We say is equals to okay, let me do it like this. I think this will be the easiest way to do it. Let me do it in a form of ratio. So because this is common, eh? I'm gonna say $1 is the same as this comma 6 9, right? And therefore, what I'm going to do is I'm gonna say 1 euro, 1 euro is gonna be the same as, I'm repeating what is given there. Don't panic and say this looks different or what. Ne? So now what am I actually going to do in this case? I'm going to look for 1 rand. Ne? One rand is equals to how much? Using this ratio over here, I'm gonna divide both sides by 13 so that I can left with rand. Okay? So I divide both sides by 13. So when I divide both sides by 13 of that equation, it's six, what, it's $6, $9. And then this side I'm gonna left with which is 1 rand. 1 rand is the same as this. You understand? Even on this equation, I'm gonna do the exact same thing. I'm gonna divide by 11.52. I'm going to divide by 11.52. Even this side, I'm going to divide by 11.52. So this side, I'm going to have 1 divided by 11.52. I have my euro there, which is equals to 1 rand. Now, having a look at these two equations, I can see that this is 1, right? This is 1. It is the same. 1 rand and 1 rand, it is the same. Therefore, I'm going to equate these two equations. I'm going to say this equation is now the same as this equation. I get it because here I have 1 rand. And therefore, there I also have 1 rand. So 1 rand is the same as 1 rand, right? So that means this side is going to be the same as that side, meaning 1 over 13.69 dollars is going to be the same as 1 over 11.52 euros. Now, because I want to determine $1, what am I going to do? I'm going to divide the whole thing by this, or I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal. So what is the reciprocal of this? It's going to be 13.69 over 1. Remember, what I do on this side, I supposed to do it on the other side of the equation. Then here I have 13.69 divided by 1, right? And therefore, this will cancel this. 1 multiplied by 1 will be 1. And therefore, this side, I'm going to have $1. I'm going to left with 1, right? And therefore, let's see. When I do this on my calculator, I'm going to say 13.69 divided by what? By 11.52. And therefore, to two decimal places, I get 1.19 euros. Why am I writing E like that? Euros. Okay, therefore, that means this will be my final answer. So that means $1 will be the same as 1 euro. Even this side, ne, on this equation, instead of dividing by 13, you can divide by, you can multiply the whole equation by the reciprocal of this 11.52. You'll get 1 euro this side, and it will show you 1 euro is equals to how many dollars. It does not matter whether you convert from $1 to euros or from 1 euro to dollars. So this will be your answer. Do you all understand it? Or should I repeat it?
Can you please repeat it?
No problem. I'm sure you guys are using different methods or whatever, but this is same thing. So let me repeat it once more again for the last time. Now, I'm saying to you, I'm taking this equation, right, which is $1 is equals to 13.69, right? Now, this equation, I'm going to solve for 1 rand, or I'm going to solve for R. So in order for me to solve for R on this equation, I'm going to divide by 13.69. So this side, when I divide by 13.69, I'm going to left with R. Remember, this R is the same as 1 rand. You understand? When I divide by 13.69, I'm going to left with 1, obvious, which is the same as 1 rand. So remember, this is an equation. What I do on this side, I suppose to do it on the other side. Meaning, even on this side, I'm going to have to divide by 13.69. Remember, here is 1, right? So I'm going to say 1 divide. Or, okay, I can write it like this so that maybe this is the one that is confusing you, how I wrote it at that time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say 1 also divide by 13.9. I'm going to have this 1 divide by 13.69. Maybe let me write it this side instead of that side, right? So this is equation number 1. I'll call this equation equation 1. Therefore, now I'm going to take this equation again. I hope you're focusing. I have 1 euro, which is the same as how much? 11.52. Right? Again, I wanna have 1 rand on this side. So that means I'm gonna have to eliminate 11.52. I'm gonna divide by 11.52. Even on this side, I'm gonna divide by 11.52. Why? Because this is an equation. What I do on this side, I supposed to do it on the other side of the equation. So when I divide by 11.52, I'm gonna left with 1 rand, which is R, right? Let me just write 1 rand there to show that I'm left with 1 rand. And therefore, even this side, when I divide this by 11.52, it's going to be that divided by 11.52 euros. You understand? And therefore, now this, I managed to do equation number 2. Look at equation number 1. Look at equation number 2. I have 1 rand. I have 1 rand. So I'm going to say R1 from this equation is going to be the same as R1 from this equation, because 1 rand is the same as 1 rand. You understand what I'm saying? So that means, look at this R1. Is this? So I'm going to R1. This R1, it's this. 1.13.69. And therefore, look at this R1. It's this, which is, I'm equating this side again, which is 1 over 11.52. Now, I want to cancel this. I'm saying to you on this step, is that you multiply by the reciprocal of this, or you multiply by the reciprocal of this. You're gonna get one this side. If so, in this side, let me show you. This side, I have this, right? I have 1 comma 13,69. So I'm gonna multiply by the reciprocal. What is the reciprocal of that? It's 13,69 divided by 1. Right? So remember what I do on the other side of the equation, I must also do the same thing on the other side of the equation. So even this side, I'm going to multiply by the 13,69 over 1. So this and this will cancel, 1 and 1 will cancel. I'm going to have $1 this side. See, I'm going to have $1 this side. And then this side, when I punch this on my calculator, I'm gonna get my 1,19. Oh, let's not forget our euros there because you're calculating euros. So meaning $1 will be the same as 1,19 euros. You get it now. You get it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, all right, I'm happy that we all get it now. Okay. All right.